Reviews for the AMD Radeon RX 6800 and 6800 XT, they're out! And according to the Linus Tech Tips video that I just watched, the cards are very competitive compared to the RTX 3070 and 3080 when it comes to gaming, especially at 1080p. However, once you crank up that ray tracing and resolution, it's clear that Nvidia still has the upper hand thanks to their more mature ray tracing cores and extra goodies like DLSS. On the other hand, the 6800 XT is 50 bucks cheaper than the 3080, which is out of stock everywhere, so you could just pick up one of the AMD cards instead. Well, that is, if they weren't experiencing the exact same stock shortages that have affected every new tech release in the past few months.
We are cursed!
Well, if we can't get an actual unit, then maybe we can get a little schadenfreude from multiple reports that have emerged of scalpers being robbed in the middle of selling their ill-gotten stock. Okay, well, no, hold on a second. Scalping is bad, but robbing people is also bad. So let's not go all like Kevin Costner, Robin Hood here, because that's not a great movie. Yeah. The reviews are also out for Apple's new M1 Max, at least by the people who Apple deemed special enough to receive their units early. And it looks like the part of Apple's presentation that was partially accurate was their claims about power efficiency. The M1 SoC appears to offer compelling performance compared to competing PCs without even having to spin up the fans on the Mac Mini or MacBook Pro in many cases. Whether the software support will be there seems to be the real question though, and many developers have released app updates with optimizations for M1. But there are also some growing pains. Google pulled Chrome for M1 Max to fix issues before re-releasing it, and Adobe's apps are a bit glitchy for the time being. But then of course, you can use Pixelmator Pro.
Yeah.
Just switch, it's easy. Oh, and you can also play World of Warcraft. I was gonna make a dozens of us joke, but I mean, are there any Mac WoW players watching this at all?
I'm actually curious.
Sound off, guys. Anthony's working on the full LTT review, by the way, so stay tuned for a real Apple fanboy's perspective. In other Apple news, the company has completely randomly decided to drop its App Store revenue cut to 15% for small developers, thanks to no actions that were taken by any other company, obviously. Wow, isn't that a coincidence? App developers making less than $1 million a year from the App Store can now take advantage of the reduced rate, which is also selectively offered to giant players like Amazon. But how will Apple survive now?
I'm worried.
Ah, well, turns out that the small developers that this policy affects actually make up around 98% of all iOS developers, but they only account for 5% of the App Store's revenue. So Apple will be just fine.
Woo!
Perhaps unsurprisingly, opponents of the so-called Apple tax, like Epic Games and Spotify, are, well, they're unimpressed because they're not getting the 15% rate after all. With the Coalition for App Fairness calling the move a symbolic gesture rather than the real change that is needed to fix the system. You know, we gotta take down the system, man. Take it down. Also, Epic Games just opened another lawsuit against Apple's App Store practices in Australia this time. So the fight is set to continue on until Epic and Apple's trial next year.
Sounds fun.
Now it's time for the Click Trits. Brought to you by Brilliant, sounds dirty, the website and app that make learning accessible and fun. Instead of making you memorize facts, Brilliant's approach is to not have you know any facts. You solve every problem as you approach it. No, I'm just kidding. So they focus on problem solving and active learning. You will need some facts. You'll encounter concepts visually with courses laid out like bite-sized pieces of a story that you can interact with. There's no tests or grades and therefore no anxiety. Pick a course that you're into and get started, whether you want to learn programming, brush up on your algebra, or dive into the science of neural networks. The first 200 of you who head to brilliant.org/techlinked will get 20% off their annual premium subscription. So click the link below and get smart now. Say it, Linus. Just say it.
Say it.
I won't.
Come on.
After Capcom downplayed the impact of a cyber attack it suffered a month ago, the company has now confirmed that files were stolen from its internal network, with info like names, addresses, and phone numbers of as many as 350,000 customers having been accessed. Hackers also made off with the source code for a number of Capcom titles which have been leaked online. This sucks. But as my grandma used to say, well, devil may cry. Boy, that was a, boy, was that a labored joke.
Well, devil may cry.
Apple has agreed to pay $113 million in another settlement over batterygate, the gate name that has been given to Apple's throttling of older iPhone batteries through a software update. Apparently, if they had just disclosed what they were doing instead of hiding it, it could have all been perfectly legal. So remember, kids, just explain clearly what you're doing next time you steal your neighbor's Wi-Fi, and there's nothing they can do about it.
Looked it up.
Actually, you're right. I was gonna say, you know you're right, right? Google has relaunched their Pay app with new features like banking, peer-to-peer payments, and financial tracking because, I mean, they know basically everything else about you. You might as well take the plunge and let them help you with your finances too. They have robots. And Oppo has unveiled a working prototype of the Oppo X 2021, a concept phone with a rollable display. It uses an internal motor to expand the display from 6.7 inches to 7.4 inches, which is fine. Don't get me wrong, but like, call me when I can unfold my phone like to monitor size, like those old paper maps that our ancient ancestors used to use. I used paper maps.
You would have thought I wrote a dick joke here.
And Twitter has added fleets, which are basically Instagram stories, at the same time that Instagram changed their notifications tab to a shopping tab, confusing users everywhere. So now Twitter's Instagram, Instagram is Amazon, Amazon is Netflix, and Netflix is live TV? So what's TikTok then?
Twitch.
Well, Techlinked is over, or at least this episode is, so come back on Friday for more tech news. Three times a week, baby! We got you! Oh, I fell off my box.
Oh.
I'm fine.
It's unsafe.